says the said respondents are in charge of the security systems in this country, and if they are unable to have knowledge of the reports widely covered in the media, then they do not deserve to occupy the positions they do occupy, since their positions are at the heart of this country, conducted themselves in a most despicable manner not expected in this constitutional era. I reiterate what I said in the earlier ruling, that those who disobey court orders risk being declared by the court for a breach of Article 10 of the Constitution, which prescribes national values and principles of governance, with the attendant consequences, among other appropriate sanctions. In deciding what sanction to meet, this court must reflect on the need to maintain the rule of law and ensure that the authority and dignity of our courts are upheld at all times, and to stamp the court's authority and uphold the values and principles of governance enshrined in Article 10 of the Constitution. In this case, the fact that respondents have not adhered to the oath of office which they took to inter alia protect the Constitution of this country, including national values and principles of governance. To the contrary, the manner in which they have conducted themselves in these proceedings does not inspire confidence at all. This is contrary to Article 74 of the Constitution, which provides that a state officer shall behave, whether in public and official life, in private life, or in association with other persons, in a manner that inter alia avoids demeaning the officer holds. The provision proceeds to state that such an officer may, in accordance with the disciplinary procedure, be dismissed or otherwise removed from office, where the officer is so removed, he or she is thereby disqualified from holding any public office. I have been asked to impose very stiff sentences against the contemnors herein. However, due to reasons which this court cannot fathom, Parliament in its wisdom limited the powers of this court to imposition of a sentence of not more than 6 months in prison, or Kenya shillings 200,000 or both. In this case, it's clear that the respondents are the ones in charge of security in this country. They are, in effect, in charge of execution of warrants of arrest. They have clearly shown that they have no respect for the rule of law and will not comply with the orders of this court. To my mind, even if the citizens were to arrest them, they'll still be placed at the disposal of their juniors. And if they can disobey and disregard the orders of this court with such impunity, I do not see how any of their juniors will execute the warrants against them, or even hold them in custody if arrested by citizens. This court, like any other court of law, ought not to make orders in vain. I must make sure that the orders bite, as Kimaro J said. It must not only make effective orders, but orders whose execution can be carried out swiftly and efficiently, and orders which it can supervise. It must not issue orders which, from the circumstances of the case, there is high likelihood that they will not be implemented, whether rightly or not. In the premises, it's my view that the most appropriate orders to make are declaratory orders, and orders in nature for fine. Regrettably, I reiterate, this court's pecuniary limit in cases of a fine is limited to Kenya shillings 20,000. Whereas it was submitted, there are several acts of contempt, and I agree each act ought to carry its own penalty. The matter before me concerns contempt found to have been committed by the contemnors yesterday. If there are other acts of contempt, the petitioner is at liberty to pursue the same. Similarly, the petitioner or any other Kenyan is at liberty to take any other or further action pursuant to the orders of this court. Therefore, the orders which commend themselves to me and which I hereby issue are as follows. One, a declaration that the first, second, and third respondents have violated Article 10 of the Constitution by failing to adhere to the rule of law in the sense that they have brazenly disobeyed the orders of this court. It is, however, not appropriate in these proceedings to declare them unsuitable to hold public offices. That is a matter for another forum. Two, each of the first, second, and third respondents are hereby penalized to pay a fine of Kenya shillings 200,000 personally. The said sum will be deducted directly from their next month's salaries, and the deputy registrar of this court is directed to transmit the order of this court to their respective employers forthwith. Those shall be the orders of this court.
We are much obliged. My Lord, there was a question of returning Mr. Miguna to the jurisdiction of the court because this matter is still ongoing. I don't know whether your Lordship did not find it convenient, although you are dealing with the issue of sentence. But in order for the court to supervise, you know, the contempt violations, it would be necessary that the petitioner is available in case we need to make any other application.
Judge Mweta made very specific orders.
Yes.
Which are very clear. Those orders still stand. They have not been superseded by this particular order. In this order, only dealing with contempt of court, but the orders of any judge made in these proceedings still stand, and they have to be complied with, and as I said, if there are any acts of contempt which have been committed, the petitioner is at liberty to move and actually seek orders for the respondents to be penalized. So the orders that have been given are still in force. They have to be complied with. And when this matter comes before Judge Mweta on the 6th of April, I think you are at liberty to pursue them.
Yeah. Then the only other issue is the question of the passport. They complied in part to Justice Mweta's orders, and that is at the core of these proceedings. I don't know whether your Lordship could bend backwards and direct that a valid passport be made available to the petitioner, if that can find favor with the court.
Judge Mweta didn't deal with that particular issue.
He dealt with it, yes. But they complied in their own way. Instead of Judge Mweta's order was that they deposit a valid passport.
Yes.
Yes. That they deposit a valid Kenyan passport. But what they subsequently did was to submit a passport which was perforated, which then it meant that the petitioner could not use it.
I really don't have to
In fact, it may be just a question of validation.
I don't have to make the same orders again. If those orders have been made by Judge Kimaru,
yes,
then they are under obligation to actually provide a valid passport.
Yes.
And of course, we all know what a valid passport is.
Yes.
So actually, you are at liberty to actually pursue them, and you are at liberty to even pursue the contempt of orders which I may have made in this particular file,
yes,
which are not actually subject of the sentence.
Of the sentence, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Because I've not dealt with them.
Yes.
I've only dealt with actually what I did yesterday. But what happened maybe after I gave the orders, and today, I've not dealt with.
So the show conceit continues then. We are much obliged otherwise.
Thank you.
The hearing of 6th of April stands.
It stands.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Much obliged.
I know that before
yes.
you rise up,
yes.
may I make an application for contempt proceedings?
Yes.
And in the meantime, my Lord, if you can make another that we be supplied with the
handwritten. Can it be heard?
My Lord, your initial order that they have no right of audience still stands. I think the tools are down until such a time as that one is complied with or the Court of Appeal says otherwise.
Including serving sentence. You have committed a sentence.
I think somebody has applied for proceedings.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So I think the typing is in process.
May I request for the handwritten note?
The handwritten notes?
Yes.
Copies of proceedings to be supplied to parties, and parties are also at liberty to make copies of the handwritten notes of this court.
Much obliged.
Thank you.